All right, we are just a couple minutes out from, actually under a minute out from Atom of Code. Late stream starting. I was getting a couple of utilities implemented, namely a auto submission thing. So we'll see how this goes. Okay. What do we have? Okay, what is the expected answer on this? Thirteen. Okay, so we have some sort of thing with a direction. Magnitude. So FS1. Okay. Right. Okay. We have a visited set. I'm going to represent this as a point. Right, left. Up, right, left, and then we also have down. Okay, so up is dir equals point 01, right is 10. Left is -10, down is 0, -1. Okay. Okay, so what are the rules for tail? So if the x I guess I'm not sure what to do when it goes diagonally down, but okay, I guess it just goes one to the right. So let's deal with the x direction. Is less than another dot. No, wait. If the head, yeah, head plus one is less than tail.x. Okay, and then I guess, how does the y work? I think it works the same way. I think it probably does. Well, darn. Okay, I think I need to step through this. 0 0 1 0 0 0. Two zero, one zero, three zero, one zero, or two zero, four zero, three zero, four one, three zero, four three, 4332 should be 4332 should be 3 3. This is confusing. I guess this is what we do in these two cases. How do you move diagonally? I don't really know how to do this. So I'm gonna write some stuff down here. If we're at 0, 0, and -1, -1, and we go to 1, 0, then -2, 0, we go to -2. -2, -1, -2, I guess let's just hard code all. All the movements, I guess. Okay, so okay, so if it's in the upper quadrant of the, then we just always move diagonally to that upper quadrant. Okay, I see how this goes. How do I implement this? So first quadrant point 1, 1, second quadrant is -1, 1, third quadrant is 1, -, -, -, there we go. If head.x is greater than tail.x and head.y greater than tail.y, tail.x plus equals quads first quadrant dot x, and then the y direction the same thing. Oh, what is that? Okay. So the second quadrant is if the x is less than the tail, but the y okay, and then this one is if it's in this direction, so if the head.x is less than the tail and the head.y is also less than, and then this is if the x is greater but the y is less than. And now I'm fitting more. Well, shoot. All right. Okay. This is hard. I like this actually, though. Okay, so let's print here. Shoot. Oh. What am I doing wrong? It's just not detecting diagonal. Oh, that's what I'm doing wrong. Not waiting long enough. This even right? Oh, that's gonna be really no. Oh man, shoot. That's so bad. Oh my gosh, it was literally just my prints that were making it too slow, and I thought it was not working. All right, we're gonna do this. It's really a maybe get rid of the verbose, I guess. Okay. Yeah. We're gonna demote go test format. That really caused me pain. Okay, so I have an idea on this. So this is. Okay, what is the. How many positions the tail of the rope is at least once? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, so now what? So this is going to represent my tail, because I think that's going to be easiest. Okay, so this larger example is 36. Oh, I probably have to reassign this, right? Copy the values just to be really sure. Oh no, this is wrong. That's so frustrating. All right, how did I do? Pretty bad. What's the damage on the leaderboard? This is the real question. Oh, it's not as bad as I expected, honestly. 8-5. Okay. Wow, Colin still hasn't solved part two? Okay, this was not actually the worst thing to happen. I mean, okay, I assume it's people leaderboarded today, right? Oh wait. Ordering. Let's see, did Kelly? No. Wow. People are fast. Okay. Wow, Jaden got a 3-2 finish. Impressive. Impressive. I don't think I even understood the problem at 14 minutes. So, good on him. Okay. All right, let's commit this. What is this? 09 solve. All right, so what went well today? Well, I solved it at least. Okay, so yeah, this was hard. This was like really, really annoyingly hard. It's kind of a cool problem, though. I just There's got to be a better way of doing this whole thing. Like, so in the di this is the diagonal case. And like so is there a better way of doing this? Like, I'm sure there is. This is like terrifying. I don't even know how to like make this better. Like, Okay, it looks like some people are doing like man, I don't even know. Okay, so the point of this is you have some head pointer and then a trailing tail, and you just move the head by some direction by and some magnitude. You have to do it one at a time, I guess. I guess you don't have to do this one at a time, actually. Probably best if you do it one at a time. But you move the head and the tail follows by at least, and it always maintains one distance. So I guess I can optimize this to allow for arbitrarily sized ones. Actually, I'm going to leave these. This is actually a really useful utility. I'm going to put it in my library here. There it is, points. Okay, and get rid of that. Okay. All right. Now, day two is just a superset of day one, so that's kind of nice. So, what went horribly today is that Go test format doesn't output until like it's done with all of the standard out processing. And I didn't realize that it was like actually going and working. That was really annoying. Okay, so yeah, we're demoting Go test format. We're never using that again for this. It does have a slightly worse output when you do it like this, but I think we're just gonna have to deal with it because at least it gives me output. That's our fourth quadrant. Okay, so what do we want here? So visit is set. And then I want a rope. and I plus plus rope append node.point 0.0. Return the visited length and explicitly use x and y here. Okay. And then just do this. Change this from rope minus one. And then does this still pass? Yep. And here we have 9 followers. Okay. That's at least nice. So each follower just has, so you move the head and then each follower just has some special rules. If it's leader, so the, in this, it's just whichever element is, or whichever one is closest to it, in the rope, the one that's the next closest to the front of the rope, the head of the rope, it just follows it. Okay, let's see if we, do we need this stuff? Yes. Can we just say equals leader? Yes. Okay. All right. Yeah, so if the y's are equal and it's gotten too far away, then you just move in that direction. Or same with the X's. And then if we are already within one of the, I guess I should just do if, else if this is greater than, that should do it. Yeah. Okay. So if we only deal with moving if the absolute value of the Manhattan distance is, or the if the Manhattan distance is greater than 2. Actually, I think we always do this. Okay, never mind. I'm just gonna ignore that and just go with it because I don't exactly know what's going on. All right, so I think doing the direction as a point was a really good idea. I guess these are really vectors now. But I mean, points are vectors, so. All right, I don't think there's much else to do at this point. I guess I should figure out my test utilities. I was working on this before I hopped on, but the submit kind of worked. I think I'm gonna keep it. Like, let me add it to the template. Let's do a require here and a require here. And then same thing here. Do we have year anywhere? Yeah, year num. Okay, so yeah, so this was nice. It at least allowed me to submit pretty easily. I guess the other thing is that, so like, let's go over here. Go test. Okay, so if I is greater than len expected, just break. Okay, yeah, let's keep that around. That way then I don't have to do that those shenanigans. This was just like, so part two, I needed more test cases than part one. So let's just go with that. And then we have two test cases. That's nice. So the real question is, when am I gonna feel confident enough to just like uncomment this? Because it's kind of nice, like, you know, it seems I don't want to DDoS the servers. I'll just leave it like this. I think it's fine. Sort of make it explicit when I want to actually submit. I just will uncomment that or remove this line here. Okay, let's call it a day. Thanks for watching. If you're on YouTube, I do stream this live every day on Twitch, so follow me in the description below. And I will see you tomorrow.